Welcome to the second period of virtual lab superposition verification of superposition theorem.
In case of a transmission, whether it should be the long transmission line, whether it should be the short transmission line, right? In case of a transmission, the implementation of the differential potential, implementation of the differential potential, that will be required for the communication channel.
And guys, you can see this board. Please all join all. Then I will start. I will change this resistance set. Okay. Then we have to verify this.
It can be used for short feeder as we are using the short transmission line. So then one will have to short. It can be used for the short feeder. It also be known as a pilot channel. So differential potential is also called as a pilot channel, right? So this type of thing, someone is told what will be the pilot potential. The pilot potential is actually nothing but differential. Why this is called the pilot potential? Because we are considering the short transmission line. So we are considering the short transmission line. So
look, I am changing this resistance value.
Right.
I am changing this resistance value also.
For the small figure,
this is 400.
Okay, it will be also.
This is 400. And we can change also.
So we can say that the differential potential is extremely accurate. Okay,
this is 100, and this is 200.
So differential potential is very much accurate.
Look, this is 200, this is 100, and we can change this resistance also. Look what happens for the case one. We can case one, just short both, means power both, power mode, this is both. Then simulate it. You can see as this is 100 volt and this is 200 volts, that's why it is showing some negative current. Okay, and in case two, then only this is power mode and this is short mode. Okay, this is short mode. Then we are going for the simulate. You can see this type of current is flowing. We are going for the S2 as the power mode and S1 as the short mode. Then we can select this S3 mode. And we select, yes, the simulator is done. Now fill the data. Okay, we fill this data. Now we have to verify one by one whether it is coming, the resultant current is coming in this way. Now where is my calculator? You have to find out your calculator.
Yes, okay. Are you there?
Yes, this current. Look, this is branch one current due to V1 and this is branch one current due to V2. We have to summation. 0.31034 and this is plus. This is minus 0.34483. Look, this type of current is coming minus 0.3449, 0.034483. Look, this is also coming minus 0.03449. This is truncated up to 9. Okay. But why they are truncated into this putting 3 and this is 9. Okay, this is the difference of this calculator. Okay. Now we have to verify this. Okay. So this is coming for the V1 source. This is minus 0.17241. Okay. And this branch current is coming 0.41379. So we have to summation.
We don't know whether from the sending end, suppose to be, from the sending end, okay, sending end, it may happen that the sending end current is this way, or the receiving end current is this way. Okay, so what the basic principle that will show the deeper end state,
and this is coming, I2, that is coming. Just cancel it. First, it is I2 0 point, yes, is 20. This is, sorry, here is coming 0 first minus 0 point. Okay. 0 point, so this 17241. Okay, and it is coming 4 point plus 0.41379. Now it is coming 0.24138. So 0.24138, exactly it is coming. Okay, so it is also verified. Now we have to verify the current I3 when both V1 and V2 are working. It is giving 0.20690, but we are getting when I3, when V1 is only, then it is coming 0.13793. And we can sum with this current when I3 due to the V2, then 0.068966. That is 0.13793, and this is plus is 0.068966. Is that coming? Yes, it is coming. 0.20690. 206. Here is something is there, but they are giving this type of amount. Okay, so up to this, it is correct. Up to 4 digit, it is almost correct. Because 9 is truncated to 8 is became 9. So you can see the superposition theorem is verified for all angle. Okay, we have changed this voltage source. We can change the resistance source or value of the resistance also. But we can find, yes, this statement is right. Because when only one voltage source is working, then the current and only two voltage source, both voltage sources are coming, are working, then it is the sum of these individual sources. So guys, I think you can understand this thing. Please perform it by your own. Guys, you can see Miss Anjali Kumari, Khushbu Kumari, Mushkan Dubey, Rohit Kumar, Rajan Kumari, Suraj Kumar. Please perform it in your own laptop or mobile, and you have to share it. Then I can understand you are performing. Otherwise, only I can perform, you only see, then it is not completed.
With my wife, I will share with you other things the next topic.
Guys, please perform it and show this type of table, perform it. Guys, please show your screen.
That is actually the main objective. Okay. So this is also under the difference. So this is very important. The point is the differential potential for the transmission. So this is my differential potential. Differential potential for transmission. Line. It will be having a gap. So how could I see this? I already wrote the principle of operation of differential protection. The same thing we are implementing in the gap line of operation. Okay. So the differential protection can be used for the gap line. That means gap line is actually nothing but a multi-terminal line. So the gap line is actually nothing but a gap line is actually nothing but a multi-terminal. So there will be the n number of terminals from the one single transmission. Right. So we can say that the gap line is also nothing but a multi-terminal. Multi-terminal line. Okay, so suppose we have a one major transmission line. Okay, so from there we have a several transmission. So this particular section we will consider in the pattern. Okay, so several transmission line that will go in the various section. Right, so that particular section is actually part of that. That means there must have a, in this particular section.
Guys, please show your screen. After performing, show your screen. Multiple user can share your screen. So one by one, show. Otherwise, I will not able to give you the attendance. Only these sevens are here, the second class.
Suppose in this particular.
Please show your screen, this type of screen, and show your data. Multiple user can share. Then I can understand, yes, you can perform. Otherwise, lab performance will not over. Guys, please show your screen. Perform it in your own laptop or your own mobile, then show what are the results. guys, here you can get some quiz. Through this quiz, you can understand, you can verify your knowledge also. The first start. Look, find I1 and V2 with a source value as shown. Okay, this source, two source are given. The source value is divided by 2. The source value is divided by 2. And C, the source value multiplied by 2. Okay, note the principle of proportionality applies in B and C. So what is this? This is one type of questions.
From the cap line.
Just solve it.
So this is actually the definition protection figure.
Find I1, V2 with, this is question number A. The source value is as shown. B, the source value is divided by 2. And C, source value is multiplied by minus 2. Okay, note the principle of proportionality applies B and C.
Okay, so for that case, we have a different value of the current. Okay, so if suppose this segment we are considering over here, in this segment.
Now, second question, find V and I in the circuit given below. You can see there is a voltage source. There is a voltage source. This is plus and minus. Direction is given. And this is the resistance. Okay. But here is some current is flowing. The current direction is also given. So only current is given. Only current source is given. You have to find it out. Okay. Now, in this circuit, current to the 5 ohm resistor using the principle of superposition is find the current by using this principle. Okay. And this is find I in the circuit in the figure below. Current, find the I in the circuit in the figure below. Okay. In the circuit, this is question number 5. Circuit, current through the 5 ohm resistor using the principle of the superposition theorem. You can see very nice, only one resistance is there. So this is very simple. Okay.
So from the preliminary basis, we are only considering.
Find the current through the 3J ohm resistor using the principle of superposition theorem. Okay, this is the resistance. This is the AC.
Short transmission line having AC section. Okay, and the tapping will be taken into consideration at the point of OC.
Okay, so here is some quizzes also available. So if you want to perform, then you can use this.
The three types of faults that will appear in the preliminary section. One is a fault that will be appeared in the section.
And here is some reference book. Book name A. Chakraborty Circuit Theory. Analysis and synthesis, and this is the Bruce Carlos. This is Parker Smith.
So, under
video lecture, it is also available. If you want to know more better video, this is from IITs and NITs throughout our country, and this is NPTEL video lecture also available.
In the case one. In the case one,
so guys, please show your screen so that I can understand that you are performing. Otherwise, your attendance will not be given.
Right. So whenever the fault will not occur in the section, each and every section, suppose if one will not be appear, if two will not be appear, and if three will not be appear.
Guys, you can
then what is actually happening?
You can perform it in your mobile.
For that case, the I1,
yes, all this it is coming. Now, in first time, it was this type of things are not available here. Here you can find. Here is the first. This is the two sources are working simultaneously, but we have to find out when each one is available. So in this figure, superposition is let us first take the source V1 and first replacing the V2 by the short circuit and shown in the figure 2. This, and now I1 is just V1 divided by this. This is the parallel resistance R2 and R3 plus R1. So it is coming I1. It is I2 is I1 R2 R3 plus R2 plus R3. So I3 is coming I1 minus I2. This is I3. So I3 is I1 minus I2. So in this way we can find out. And next, removing the short circuit of this current V2, we can find I2 double dash, V2 by R1 R3 by R1 plus R3 plus R2. And this is I2 dash, I1 dash equal to I2 into R3 plus R1 plus R3. This is the current division rule. Okay. And this is I3 is I2 minus I1. So as per the superposition, I3 is I3 1 dash, I3 2 dash, I2 is the I2 1 dash, I2 2 dash, and I1 is I1 dash minus I2 dash. Okay. So in this way, we can perform this experiment. So guys, please perform through your simulator, then you can show.
Okay, so so that is actually happened. That is actually happened due to the fault one, fault two, and the fault three. Okay, so that is actually for the tap line. For the tap line. So for that case also, if I will consider another two tap points, which will be considered as the D and the E point. Okay. So suppose for that case also, under no fault condition, in case of case one, in case one, under no fault condition, under no fault condition, where under no fault condition. So for that case, I1 plus I2 plus I3.
Guys, perform your own hand, then show me. I'll give you 10 or 5 minutes. Please show your performance.
In the next thing, we have the discussion of a transferable, because there the differential protection has a different implementation for the different equipment of electrical equipment. So the differential protection for a dedicated equipment of fault is an alternative option we are asked to consider. Okay, so suppose to be using the differential protection, we have to protect the transformers. So using the differential protection, we have to protect the generators, and the differential protection, using the differential protection, we have to protect the bus stops. So the differential protection is having a big number of application area in the field of electricity, right? So we have, using the differential protection, we have to protect mainly components and the electricity, right? So suppose we have using the differential protection, we have to protect the transformers. Using the differential protection, we have to protect the generators. Using the differential protection, we have to protect the bus stops also, right? So there must have a huge application area of the differential protection. That is why the differential protection is actually called the accurate protection. Okay, so there must have an accurate value which we will give from the differential protection rather than the other protection we already discussed in the previous. Okay. So now we will discuss about the differential protections.
Guys, please show your screen one by one, then I can understand whatever you can get. And in your WhatsApp, I am sending you the link where you can get, we can apply the feedback. If you don't put feedback, then your attendance will not be completed. Okay. So after performing this, you can fill the feedback, and feedback is sent to your WhatsApp. Okay, guys, I am going to stop here, and you have to put the feedback to this link which is shared in your group. Otherwise, your attendance will not be completed. Okay, thank you.